audio innovator Bob Heil earned the admiration and confidence of a who's who of rock. Jerry Garcia, Pete Townsend, Joe Walsh, Peter Frampton, John Bon Jovi, and scores of others. All who work in pro audio are indebted to him. He built the first electronic crossover. He developed the first modular console, the first quadraphonic mixer, and the modern talk box. In his own self-deprecating words, it's all pretty good for a snot-nosed organ player from Marissa, Illinois. By 15, the prodigy was performing on the mighty Wurlitzer organ at the Fox Theater in St. Louis. He also learned how to tune the beast and learned how it worked, setting the foundation for a lifelong pursuit of innovation. In 1966, he opened Ye Olde Music Shop in his hometown. Heil's inclination for all things audio evolved into creating sound systems. His first was used for a radio station's monthly show, and there he worked with stars like Roy Clark, Dolly Parton, and Loretta Lynn. Soon the likes of Jimi Hendrix, Ted Nugent, and Janis Joplin also benefited from the sound system. It was 1970 when Heil took a call to help out the Grateful Dead. It seemed the band had showed up that afternoon for a gig without their PA. As hard as it is to believe, it seems to have been confiscated as part of a drug investigation. When Garcia learned of Heil's gear, which included Macintosh, RCA, Olsen bins, and lots of JBL horns, he knew the show would go on. And that one show changed the sound reinforcement world forever. Ye Olde Music hit the front page of Billboard magazine for Saving the Dead's tour. Suddenly, his systems were in demand. His method of using multiple stages in between massive left, center, and right speaker systems vastly improved the sound quality of live outdoor and arena events. Heil's system attracted the attention of Paul Klipsch, father of the folded horn, who flew to Marissa to see the 50,000-watt PA system. Klipsch was impressed, and he taught Heil about speaker loading, tuning, phasing, and other tricks of the trade. By 1971, Heil met up with Joe Walsh. It was then that Heil came up with a usable talk box that was featured on Rocky Mountain Way. Frampton, too, would soon use the box in his career-making Frampton Comes Alive. The revered box is still made and sold today to Heil specifications. Meanwhile, Ye Olde Music had become the largest Sun amplifier dealer in the country, and Heil was asked to design and build the Sun Coliseum series. While touring the Midwest with Wild Cherry and the new system, he again took a call from a band in need. The next day, he was on a 707 for Boston to set it up for The Who. The Who had not toured the United States for years and were ill-prepared. The crowds couldn't hear them and the reviews were scathing. But all it took was a Heil-styled sound check to make it all right. Townsend remarked later, it was the first sound system that even they couldn't outplay. Next, the snot-nosed organ player was on his way to London. Townsend wanted to use quadraphonic sound for his next opera. Was that possible to do in a live concert setting? Yes, Heil said. Townsend told Heil if he could build it, he would write the opera for it. Others who have sounded great because of Heil's genius include Frank Zappa, Jeff Beck, Chicago, the Beach Boys, and of course, Peter Frampton. Frampton said of Heil, Bob is one of the nicest guys in the business. He's a guy that doesn't think of the money first. Yes, it's a business, but he's always there to help you if he can. Ye Olde Music Shop was sold in 1974 to allow Heil to spend more time designing and producing professional sound systems. He was the first to design a modular touring console, modular power amplifier, electronic crossover, and parametric EQ. Many of his designs are still in use more than 30 years later. In 1982, Bob left the music industry to follow other interests, but recently was coaxed back by Walsh, who was complaining that there's been no new microphone technology. Today, Heil is back in business with Heil Sound, producing new mics being used by Velvet Revolver, ZZ Top, American Idol, and a host of hot young producers. The roster is growing daily. Yet, in his mind, he's still the 15-year-old tinkering with that big Wurlitzer organ using his most important tool, his ears. Hearing is a physical process, he explains. Listening is a mental process. And there are not many good listeners on the planet. Bob Heil has listened for all of us. And it's been to the betterment of the entire pro audio industry. And for that, we are grateful. Bob Heil, winner of the 2007 Parnelli Audio Innovator Award.